डियर लिसनर, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। टॉपिक ऑफ दिस वीडियो इज डिसीजन ट्री ID3 एल्गोरिदम। दिस इज पार्ट 3 एंड इट इज कवर्स द एडिशनल एक्सरसाइज ऑन ID3 एल्गोरिदम। इन पार्ट 1 एंड पार्ट 2 आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन द कंसेप्ट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन थ्योरी सच एज प्रोबेबिलिटी एंड एंट्रोपी इन डिटेल विथ एग्जाम्पल। एज ID3 एल्गोरिदम और डिसीजन ट्री इज बेसिकली डिपेंड ऑन दिस बोथ कंसेप्ट, दैट इज एंट्रोपी एंड प्रोबेबिलिटी। दीज आर द लिंक ऑफ पार्ट 1 एंड Part 2. We see on the fast track decision tree algorithm. It is classification, that is supervised learning technique. It builds the model in the form of tree. It breaks down a data set into smaller and smaller subset as decision tree is incrementally developed. It has decision nodes, that is attribute, and leaf node, that is final classification label. Root of the decision tree is the best predictor node. It uses concept of entropy and information gain for construction of decision tree. It is based on greedy approach. Backtracking is not used. Tree is constructed in top-down and recursive manner. Let us see the formula of entropy. H is equal to negative summation of p of x into log to p of x, where p of x is a probability. As H is entropy, that is measure of randomness in data. In the formula of entropy, negative sign is there, but entropy is always positive. Four steps are there. After that, these steps are again continuously repeated until every record gets classified. Step 1, entropy is calculated for entire database. Entropy is calculated for each attribute. Entropy having the highest gain is selected as a decision node. Gain is nothing but the difference between the entropy of the entire table and of that particular attribute. The attribute who having the highest gain is selected as a decision node. Database D is divided into smaller subset according to the category of decision node. Repeat step 1 to 4 unless every record gets classified. Now let us see the problem. In this problem, total 14 records are there. First attribute is age, then income, third is student, fourth is credit rating, and final is our class label, that is classification label by its computer, which belongs to either yes or no. Step 1 is calculate the entropy for the class label. Now, total 14 records are there, out of which 9 are yes and 5 are no. We calculate the entropy, that is summation of probability of both types, minus 9 by 14 into log to 9 by 14, that is for the yes case, and this is for the no case, that is 5 by 14 into log to 5 by 14. After calculation, we are getting the answer 0.94. Now 0.94 is the entropy of entire table. Now we consider the particular attribute age. In age, three categories are there, less than or equal to 30, 31 to 40, and greater than 40. Now we first create the table, that is three categories, and in each category, how many belongs to the yes and how many belongs to the no. For example, less than 30, total 5 records are there, out of which 2 are belong to the yes category and 3 are belong to the no category, 31 to 40 and greater than 40. Here, whenever one of the attribute is, one of the probability is 0, our final answer is 0. And whenever equiprobable case comes, our answer is 1. That I have already explained in part 1 video, that why it comes, when it comes equiprobable, why it comes 0, everything theoretical aspect of entropy. Now here, 2, 3 and 3, 2, distribution is same, therefore our answer is same. So there is no need to calculate twice. Now age less than 30. Now don't consider the 14 records. We require to do calculate only for this particular category, that is 5 records. Therefore 2 by 5 combination and 3 by combination. After the calculation, we get the answer 0.97. 31 to 40 range, we can even directly write down the answer 0 because one of the probability is 0. Greater than 40, we are getting the answer same, that is 0.97. Now this entropy is for this particular category. Now we require to calculate entropy for entire attribute, that is age. So we require to multiply with a particular proportion with that particular entropy value. Now less than 35 records are there, therefore 5 by 14 into 0.97 plus 4 by 14 into 0 plus 5 by 14 into 0.97, and we are getting the answer 0.69. gain is nothing but the difference between the entropy of entire table and particular attribute. Therefore 0.94 minus 0.69 is equal to 0.25. Similarly, we do for the income, that three ranges are there. We calculate total high, low, medium. After that, in that particular category, whenever equiprobable is there, our answer is 1. For other, we require to calculate. Then we calculate the entropy for the income attribute by considering this particular proportion, that is 4 by 14 into 1, 4 by 14 into 0.81 plus 6 by 14 into 0.92. We are getting the answer 0.91. And after that, we calculate the same formula, that is for gain, and we are getting as 0.03. Similarly for student, in student 2 range are there, make the difference that how many belongs to the yes category, how many belongs to the no category. There is 3, 4 and 6 1 combination is there. So we do the calculation with total 7 records. That is 3 by 7 and 1 combination is 4 by 7. And we are getting the answer as 0.9, 0.59. Again, we require to calculate entropy for entire attribute student. Multiply with the particular proportion into that particular probability. That is 7 by 14 into 0.99 plus 7 by 14 into 0.59. We are getting the answer 0.79. And their difference of the probabilities is nothing but the gain, and gain is 0.15. Similarly, the operation or similarly calculation we perform for the credit rating, fair and excellent. 3-3 equiprobable case, we can directly write the answer 1. We can calculate for 6-2 with total 8 records are there. Multiply with the particular proportion, entropy calculated, and after that with the difference we calculate the gain. Now here, after working with all four attributes, we are writing their attributes and gain, and we can find out the gain of the age is very high. Therefore, it becomes our best predictor node or decision node. Here we start incrementally to develop the decision tree. Basic or root node is age. In age, three categories are there, less than or equal to 30, 31 to 40 and greater than 40. Now here, our data set, which is of 14 records, is divided along these three categories. Now first, age less than or equal to 30, age greater than 40 and age between 31 to 40. So 14 records are divided into 5 records, 5 records and 4 records. Now here yes no combination is there, here also yes no combination is there, but here 31 to 40, just observe that whatever the combination of the of that income, student and credit rating by its computer is always yes. Means what? There is no need of further classification. So we can directly write down the answer. Whenever age is under the category of 31 to 40, bias computer is yes. Now we require to do for age less than or equal to 30. No and yes combination is there. Just observe the particular attribute, that student and bias computer relation. Student, whenever no, our answer is no. And whenever student is yes, our answer is yes. Just remember, and we can check that the gain of the student is higher than the income and credit rating. Now here we require to check, that is recursive procedure. Now our table becomes of only 5 records, in which 3 are no and 2 are yes. We calculate the entropy. Now there is no need to calculate for 14 records because we already divided under that particular category of less than 30. Now here 0.97. Now remaining attributes are income, student and credit rating. We follow the same procedure with 5 records. Income, high, low, medium, 0, 2, answer is 0, 1, 0, answer is 0, 1, 1, answer is 1. Multiply with the particular proportion, that is 0.4, and we are getting the gain as 0.57. Similarly for student, 0, 3, 2, 0, no need of calculation. As your entropy is 0, that is no randomness in data, our gain is highest, that is 0.97. Similarly for credit rating, we are getting 1-1 equiprobable, 1-2 we do the calculation, we are getting 0.92. Multiply with the particular proportion and here we are getting the gain as 0.02. For age less than or equal to 30, for attribute income, student and credit rating, see the gain of the student is high, 0.57, 0.97, 0.02. Now here student is more, so under less than or equal to 30 category, our next range is student. Now we again require to divide the table along the S category and no category. Now see, this is our original table. We again divide the table into two categories because we are getting the student attribute having the highest gain. Therefore, age less than 30 and student equal to S, age less than 30 and student equal to no. If we divide the table, that three records, five records are divided into two tables, that is with the two records and three records, we can see that here all records belong to the yes, all records belong to the no. So there is no use of income and crediting as such. Therefore, there is no need of further classification. So we can directly write down whenever student is yes, yes, and whenever student is no, no. That is vice computer, no. Now we require to follow the same procedure for age greater than 40. Five records are there. Again, do some analysis that just observe the credit rating and vice computer. Whenever credit rating is fair, we are getting the yes answer, and whenever credit rating is excellent, we are getting the no answer. Now total records are 5. 3 belongs to the yes category, 2 belongs to the no category. There is no need to perform the calculation again because previous also we are getting the similar case. So we can directly copy down the answer, that is 0.97. Next is income, 2-1. It is already comes the case, that is 2-1. So we can directly write down the answer 0.92. Equiprobable answer is 1. Multiply with the particular proportion and after that the gain finding. So we are getting the gain at 0.02. For student, 1-1 equiprobable, 2-1 combination is there. Again, we are getting the 0.02. Next, credit rating. Now see, in credit rating, we get the entropy 0. When the entropy is 0, the gain is always maximum. So 3/5 × 0 and 2/, that is a proportion. Gain is, entropy is 0 and gain is 0.94. Sorry, here it is 0.97. Now, income, student and credit rating, 0.02, 0.02 and 0.97. Now see, we can get the credit rating as the highest gain. Now, greater than 40, under this we are getting this credit rating. Under, again, we are dividing our table according to these two categories, fair and excellent. Just see, this is the original record. Age greater than 40, credit rating fair, we are getting continuously yes. Credit rating excellent, we are getting the no. So there is no need of further classification because whatever the combination of income and student, we always get the answer yes and for fair and no for excellent. So in this way, all records get classified. So this is nothing but our final decision tree. From the final decision tree, we generate the decision rules. R1, if age is 31 to 40, by computer is yes. If age is less than or equal to 30, student is yes, yes. If age is less than 30, student is no, no. If age is greater than 40, credit rating is fair, yes. Credit rating is excellent, no. So in this way, we can write down the decision rules and we can easily convert into the SQL queries and we can do the operation. So this is nothing but all about the decision tree. So in the first three videos, I have taken the sufficient example to understand and how to solve the decision tree algorithm. Thank you for listening my video. If you like my video, subscribe my channel for my motivation. Thank you.